all over him, but he comes out front, tries to center. He's checked. Now he takes his man down, but Lombardi's able to play the puck to center while down on the ice. Donovan picks it up to Niemann, and he moves in on the right wing. Niemann takes the shot. Now he'll let one go. That's blocked. Warner on the rebound with a slapper. Let it go as he spun, and Alex Ault was able to fork that one out of the air with a glove.
Well, if everybody on the Canuck team works as hard as Matt Cook the rest of this hockey game, I would say their chances of success would be pretty good. But unfortunately, not everybody's working like the Cooker. But when he battles like this, and I love that line I describe him, everybody loves the Cooker. When he battles like this, he wins so many of them. He's not the biggest guy on the ice by a long shot. Just goes to show you what determination can do for a hockey player who wants it.
2.5 minutes into the second period, no score here. Jovanovski, another guy who wants it badly. Nice pass to center. Here's Brad May. He's checked off the puck, and the Flames play it back into the Vancouver zone. Jovanovski has it. Tried to advance it, but Kobesu got his stick in there, and the puck deflects out of play in the Canuck zone. 2:45 into this scoreless second period, and now we have some talking on the end boards, and Malik mixing it up with Yell. Started with Kobesu going down. He was hooked up with Jovanovski, and now Yell and Malik have gotten into the act.
Well, feelings, it's starting to percolate again here now. I wouldn't say there's been real bad blood between these two teams. It's been a tough series, but I don't think there's been a lot of yapping, you know, that you see with teams that just outright don't like each other. This has always been a relatively good rivalry, due mainly to the closeness of the two teams. But, you know, when you haven't met each other for a long time in the playoffs, the playoffs is what I think really breeds rivalries.
Here's a shot blocked by Daniel Sedin as Montador trying to let one go. Puck ricochets to center. Linden there can't handle it. And Stefan Yell plays it back deep into the Vancouver zone. Hard around to the far side. Kobesu there. Checked by Malik. And Daniel Sedin makes a nice pass to center to Linden. Linden to the Calgary line. Poke check by Montador as Trevor lost control of the puck. Yell comes back the other way. Hit by Jovanovski on the near side. Puck slides behind the net. Cleared around to the far boards to Daniel Sedin. Daniel to center, lifts the puck into the Calgary zone and peels off on a change. Linden will stay out there to apply some up-ice pressure. Bumps Montador behind the net, but Saprykin gets the puck to center. Ryshinski intercepts, shoots it in, but Linden was trapped offside. And they'll bring the faceoff all the way back into the Canucks zone. 3 minutes, 27 seconds into this second period.
You know, Stefan Yell, you know, we talked about courageous. We talked about the courage of Marek Malik playing with that sore jaw of his. And this Stefan Yell, I tell you, he's showing some courage, too, to play in Game 7 for Calgary. He is a real banged-up hockey player, but that's the beauty of these guys. They know if they don't play tonight and their team doesn't win, and they got a big summer vacation anyway. They want to be part of this.
He took a hit on his last shift from Jovanovski. Looked like he definitely felt it. Now the Flames have the Iginla line out there. Conroy from the left wing corner has the puck, sends it in front, and it was steered wide by Zelina. Sopel collects the puck up to Chubarov, and he brings it out to center with a pass to Sopel. Over the Calgary line on the right wing, Sopel stops, slides the puck in deep. Now Ryshinski's after. Tied up easily by Leopold.
Yeah,
Conroy gets the puck and dumps it ahead. Morrison holds it in, puts it in front. Ruchu spins with a shot, a weak one, and Kiprasov is able to make a left pad save. Flames dump it ahead into the Vancouver zone. Here's Zelina off the ice with a slap shot, and Ault reacting quickly, made a nice glove stop. Alex might have been overplaying it a bit to the short side, and he had to reach back to snare that puck, and he hangs on for the whistle.
Well, I think you might be right, Jordy. I hope that's not his style, where he teases the far corner for these guys because he has so much confidence in his glove hand, because he snapped it up there quite nicely, and you could see lots of room on the glove side. And in this league, he might get away with that at Manitoba, but he won't get away with that very long here at the NHL level. You really have to have your angles down pat. The guys can shoot the puck too well in this league.
That one by Zelina, and Ault made the save. Now the Canucks, Jovanovski controls in his own zone. Up to Linden, tip pass to Cook at center. Now Morrison tips the puck deep into the Calgary zone. Here comes Nazanov. As Linden heads off, his face-off duty's complete. Puck is deep in the Calgary zone. Ferentz missed it. Now it's loose on the near side. Oliwa, with just his second shift of the game, works the puck free, and Ferentz banks it down the ice. Race for it now. Malik against Donovan. Malik with a long reach. Still can't get there first. But Salo collects the puck and backhands it to center ice. Cook frees it up for Nazem. Tip pass ahead to Cook. He moves in. Centers for Nazem. Offside, says the linesman. Boy, it didn't look like it were right on the line here. As it stands, Naslund didn't take the pass cleanly, so he might not have had a chance, but still, a dubious offside call from Orisa.
Yeah, and we're pretty good about that, Shorty. You know, if they call it right, we're right on top of it. But this one, the Canucks argue, and I think they have a right for an argument, but they're going to lose it as linesman Brad Kovacic made the call. Canucks had something going there, too. Three Canuck players attacking, going into the zone.
No score. 5 minutes into the second period. Game seven as Sammy Salo drives a long one in. Kiprasov gloves it. Shoots the puck up the near side himself. Salo holds it in with a long shot. This time a blocker saved by Kiprasov. Flames now get the puck to center ice. Brian Allen passes ahead to Henrik Sedin, who backhands it into the Calgary zone. Sanderson taking a shift for the Twins here. Flames intercept the puck, clear it to the line, and out to center. Henrik has it. Brings it back into the Calgary zone on the left wing. Drop pass, Sanderson. Centers for Daniel. He just missed the pass as he was sneaking behind Steve Montador. The puck went through the crease and out the near side. Neiman in the other way. Dumps the puck behind the Vancouver goal. Brian Allen blindly clears it. Intercepted by Conroy. But now Henrik Sedin is able to chop the puck out to center. Regier has it. The birthday boy up ahead for Neiman. And he tips the puck into the Vancouver zone. Kiprasov is the chant you're hearing in the background as Jeff Sanderson plays the puck down into the Calgary zone. 6 minutes into the second period. Conroy banks the puck into Vancouver territory. This will be icing. Olin back to touch up, and we'll take a break. 13:58 to go in the second period. Game seven. It's the Canucks nothing and the Flames nothing. Mark Crawford is 1 win, 2 losses. He was 1-1 last year, had a defeat against Edmonton in his days with the Colorado Avalanche. Darryl Sutter has won 2 game 7s and lost one. This one a scoreless tie, 6 minutes into the second period. As Matthias Olin hunts down a loose puck at his own line and carries it back behind his net and starts out. Olin to center. Lead pass to Mike Keane, who flips the puck cross corner into the Calgary zone. Rashinsky's there, centers. Chubarov tried a quick shot. He couldn't get good wood on it. Now he puts it to the crease. And Kiprasov diving out to cover up. Keane was there as Chubarov made kind of a desperation pass in front, and it almost clicked.
Well, I think players should do that all the time, especially in this game, because you can get some very favorable bounces. If you don't hook up with your teammate, it can bank off a Calgary defenseman. It can bank off the goaltender. There's all kinds of good things that can happen just by you centering the puck in the traffic area there in the crease. Now, close call at the Calgary goal right there is Chubarov in desperation, as you described it, Shorty, but it almost could have been a very good move.
Linden wins the faceoff. Jovanovski to the right point to Salo. Throws the puck towards the goal. Went off Brad May's skate, and Kiprasov again covers up. Good traffic by May. Salo just threw the puck to the net. And Kiprasov had another headache to contend with.
Well, Sammy Salo had one official shot in the first period. And I think he's had at least two here in the second. Canucks have had 3 shots. I think he's had 2 of them.
He might have had all three.
In fact, he might even have all three. That's right. Come to think of it.
Canucks win another draw. Rutu on the forecheck on the inboards. Tied up by Regier. Puck cleared ahead. May intercepts. Back to the line. Salo with a long shot. That was blocked on the way through. And here comes Donovan to center. He fanned on his pass. Brian Allen intercepts. Gives the puck away to Regier. But now Linden slides it to the Calgary line. Linden playing center on this shift with May and Keith. As the Flames dump the puck back into the Vancouver zone. Race for it. Zelina gets there first. Jelan working on the left wing corner, loses the puck, and Rutu backhands it all the way down. This will be icing against Vancouver as Andrew Ferentz is back to touch up. 7 minutes, 1 second into the second period, and still no goals.
Well, listen, Jarkko Rutu finally scored a goal in this series, his first ever NHL playoff goal. Mark Crawford, you can see he's a concerned coach behind the bench right now, and he has every right to be. The longer the visiting team stays in the hockey game, it always gets a little scary. And this crowd, as we mentioned, is really quieted down, almost like they're a little scared right now, too, as Calgary hangs tough in this hockey game tonight. Whoever gets that first goal could be huge.
Niemann just missed, tipping a puck in front of the Vancouver net. Linden chips it ahead to Matt Cook. He turns on the near boards, can't move the puck out, but now it gets to center to Morrison. Morrison to the Calgary line, tips the puck in deep. Merrick Malik is going to move in as the first man on the forecheck. He hits Warner in the near corner. Morrison comes in to help out. Puts the puck in front. It's cleared away by Calgary. And here come the Flames quickly to center. Donovan trying to pull away on Jovanovski. Donovan tries to go around Jovanovski, who stayed right with him and steered the puck to the end boards. Now it's centered, and Auld reaching out grabs the puck. Sean Donovan had a career-high 18 goals this season. He only has one in this series, but he almost broke away there, only to be foiled by Jovanovski.
Well, Jovanovski has such great recovery power because he's such a beautiful skater. He can accelerate full stride within at full speed, I should say, in almost a stride or two. What happened, once Malik goes in deep, the forward has to stay back at the point. And Cook is there momentarily, but then he starts to sneak in to go to the goal. And that's why it looked like Calgary might get an outnumbered rush. So Jovanovski did a great job, certainly, to bail out his teammate Malik, who was trapped deep in the Calgary zone.
Now the Canucks move to center. Chibara with a right-wing pass for Rukiu. It was behind him. Montador intercepts over to Mike Commodore. And he plays the puck to center. Chibarov after it there. Deflects into the Vancouver bench, narrowly missing head coach Mark Crawford. And the whistle blows just shy of the eight-minute mark, second period.
Well, Jerome Iginla, here is a guy that has just been a wonderful captain, I think, for this Calgary Flame hockey team. He's had a terrific series, I think, too, when you think about it. 5 points in six games. He's been very prominent in the games Calgary has won in this series. Not so prominent, obviously, when his team hasn't won. So he's a guy. He's their go-to guy.
Cook takes a hit at center from Oleg Saprykin. Here's Conroy with a right-wing feed to Iginla, and he dumps the puck cross corner into the Vancouver zone. Cook, first man back, tips it around to the far side. Shakes off one check, but then runs into Iginla. Cook works hard, gets the puck ahead to Nazl. He can't move it out past Leopold. Now Olin intercepts near side to Sofa. Ahead to Cook, trying to split the defense. He winds up just kicking the puck in deep. Leopold has it, circling his net, clears it off the glass. Nazl intercepts. Hit by Yell. Nazl keeps fighting for the puck, works it down the boards. Leopold intercepts and backhands it down to the Vancouver line. Iginla put the hook on Allen, then let go. He didn't want to take a penalty. Allen spins away with the puck, plays it ahead himself out to center where Robin Regier intercepts. Regier up to Yell. He tips the puck in deep. And Ault's going to cover up with Nielsen right there, hoping to get a loose puck at the side of the Vancouver goal.
Shorty, you know who doesn't look right to me tonight? Marcus Nazl.
Yeah.
The Canucks captain, I think, is he just doesn't have his jump and his skating. He looks just like an ordinary skater tonight. He's a much better skater than we're seeing. I don't know if he's suffering from some injuries that haven't been reported that people don't know about. That very well could be the case. But they're going to need more out of him than we've seen so far tonight if they want to get on to the next round. If you need to count on Marcus Nazl heavily with this team, he's their sniper. He's their go-to guy. I just talked about Iginla. Well, Marcus Nazl serves that role and serves it usually very, very well for the Vancouver Canucks.
Flames were called on an offside of the Vancouver line, and the faceoff will occur where the puck was advanced between the Calgary blue line and the center ice red line. We're just about 9 minutes into the second period, no score here in game number seven. And again, Mark Crawford plays Jeff Sanderson with the Sedin twins. Canucks work the puck into the flame zone. Warner gets it in the far corner, passes ahead to Chris Clark. Can't move out past Malik. Malik twice held the puck in. Clark got it out on the third attempt. Jovanovski at his own line. Banks the puck up for Daniel Sedin. He tips it in. Henrik trying to move in on the forecheck. Angled off by Ferentz as Warner clears around to the far boards. And the puck takes a nice bounce for him all the way down the ice. Nice, but not nice enough. It'll be icing as Jovanovski goes back to touch up. And they'll face off in the Calgary zone.
Well, Jovo is one of the Canuck players. You know, the Stanley Cup means so much to this guy. He's been to a Stanley Cup final with Florida. They came up short against Mark Crawford's Colorado Avalanche at that time. But he's a guy that knows what it takes to get to the big show. And he's trying to do his utmost to lead his team here in Vancouver back to the promised land and a chance to battle for top prize. But boy, they've got a lot of work to do even here tonight. This is a stubborn, feisty, gritty Calgary hockey team.
Flames want to draw on their own zone and get the puck to center. Again, we see Linden at center with May and Keane. Brad May sends the puck behind the Calgary goal. Kiprasov leaves for Robin Regier, sends the puck up the near side. Saprykin lets it go the rest of the way. He's injured as he was hit by Sofer. Saprykin slow to get up as the Flames are called for icing. And he's badly favoring that left leg, it looks like. Well, I can't really tell which leg it is, but well, Saprykin heading off slowly, and it looks like he's shaking out the left leg.
It is the left leg, I think, too, Shorty. Initially, it looked like he was in real trouble, but I think he's able to skate it off. The trainer isn't even down there yet. One of the coaches patted him on the back. That was Rich Preston. They call him Sarge.
Sopel's left knee hit Sifrikin's left knee, and Sifrikin came away with the worst of it. Looks like he'll be all right as they face off to the left.